Hey guys, so it's always been very important to me that when I need to get to work, I can get to work as quickly as possible. But the problem is, even when I know exactly which SD card it is that I'm looking for and exactly where it is, I still have to. With everything properly arranged, the USBs are even accessible now without the need to fully open the drawer. So this is actual organization, right? Because existing drawer organizers don't organize your stuff. They just kind of divide up your stuff into smaller units of mess. So after roughly laying out the main objects in their placements, I took a photo of it for reference. I also took reference photos of some of the objects individually with rulers when I needed their detailed dimensions for tracing. This one's for my sticky notes, and do you remember those hotel cards that I like using as small whiteboards? Those go in here. Pens I don't use often will go in this bottom section, and for the pens I use often, it holds my main Sharpie, ballpoint pen, and dry erase marker. My nail clippers and lip balm with some storage below for refills. Of course, I can't have a perfect holder for everything. There will always be miscellaneous stuff, so this grid holds my dry erase marker refills and other miscellaneous knives. My favorite MagSafe chargers I want easily accessible, but yeah, they don't quite fit. If they're slightly slanted though, they fit. So everything so far has been pretty focused on organization, right? But I wanted a few modules to have some extra functionality. So this next one. Not only is this a lid that holds my screwdriver, but it can also double as a project tray on my desk for loose screws and parts when I'm disassembling stuff. For this next print, there's a hole in the back for a magnet, which can be sealed with some hot glue. This helps the scissors lock into place. Right. Shout out to the sponsor today, Ugreen. They just sent me their line of Nexode chargers, and I am in love with these things. First up, we have the Nexode Mini 45 watt charger. The charger that came with my iPad is about the same size, but it's only 20 watts. Ugreen's is more than double that at 45 watts, and it has two USB-Cs, so you can fast charge two devices at the same time. And then one size up, we have the Ugreen Nexode 65 watt charger. Apple's equivalent of this is once again way bigger, and it only has one port. Ugreen's has a nice compact design with three ports, two USB-Cs and a USB-A. And lastly, we got the big one, the Ugreen Nexode 100 watt charger. This is the full powerhouse. It can charge my iPhone three times faster than the original iPhone charger. It adjusts its power output to safeguard your devices, and it's also got a super durable shell that's designed for heat dissipation. My favorite feature on all of these, however, is the fact that the prongs all fold in for easy packing and storing. So there you have it, three super functional and just beautiful looking chargers. Whatever devices you have, these have you covered. So check out Ugreen's Nexode chargers in the links below, and huge thank you to Ugreen for sponsoring this portion of the video. Now let's get back to the drawers. So in case you haven't noticed, most of the prints done so far has no bottoms. It's a bit more obvious on black. They also start with very sparse infill. It only gets denser the higher it goes up, where more support is needed. These all contribute to reducing the amount of plastic used and of course the printing time for each of these parts. So this one's for my batteries, point and shoot, and microphone cable. For my electric screwdriver, precision screwdriver, deburring tool, and caliper. last two modules work together to hold a few things. First, the long ruler, more Sony batteries, Sony microphone, and my favorite tape measure, vinyl weeding tool, and these tiny scissors. A bin for miscellaneous hardware. And last but definitely not least, I wanted to include some of these holders for organizing screwdriver bits. But I realized I kind of hate these things. The bits are always hard to remove and put back in. They're actually pretty annoying to use. So here's what I came up with instead. So now I can grab the bits I need very easily. I can grab them on their own, or take the whole roll to use on my desk. To avoid clutter, I can also stick them to the front of my drawers, since of course they're magnetic. So if you're interested in doing a project like this, here are a few things to keep in mind. For starters, you don't have to start from scratch. There are a lot of really cool organization systems online like Gridfinity, which are open source and have a lot of different modules already designed, openly available, and completely free. Secondly, consider how you might maximize vertical space. My organizer designs here allow the drawers to hold significantly more items than what it used to, with all the items just laying flat. And lastly, arrange your items in a hierarchy. I have the stuff that I use the most accessible at the very front, followed by the less important stuff and the longer items that can reach all the way to the back. This ensures that the back of the drawer is being fully utilized as well. So I worked on this project almost throughout all of 2022. It's the kind of project that you just know would take way too much of your time. In fact, I actually put it off for a long time until I started to treat it as productive procrastination. Basically, every time I would get bored with another project or when something is taking way too long, I would open this project and just kind of slowly chip away at it. It was a lot easier to work on with no deadlines and no stress. So it was nice to consistently feel a sense of accomplishment every time I finished another module. So even if I was procrastinating from my other projects, I was also being productive in a way. It was so worth it too, because this is definitely one of my favorite projects in a while. This has changed so much about how I use my drawer. When I need to grab something, I don't even really need to look anymore. Like, here's my point and shoot, here's my phone battery, here's my dry erase marker. Isn't that awesome? I even started thinking about maybe doing this for other disorganized drawers in my life, like maybe my kitchen utensil drawer. Sometimes I do wonder if maybe this is a bit too much though, but then I look at it and it's just so beautiful. So yeah, I guess since I like it a lot and I made it for myself, I guess that's enough, right? Thanks for watching, everyone.